Good morning, everyone. Last week we showed you how to hook flounder. This week we're going to show you how to cook it. Chef Ernie Danjean of the Dockside Cafe shared his family recipe for versatile crab meat stuffing.
All right, guys, I'm going to teach you my family recipe for crab meat stuffing. It's fantastic. And there's a little secret I do. Is if you notice right here, guys, this is my secret weapon. I actually take green bell pepper, red bell pepper, celery, yellow onion, onion shallots, and I saute it down to it's almost translucent, okay? Then you want to let that cool a little bit before you add it into your mixture. We're going to add that into our mixing bowl, and I've got 2 cups of mayo, which is one order, in here with that, okay? This is seasoned Italian breadcrumbs. I like panko, but I also like to add the seasoned breadcrumbs too. It just kind of holds it together really nicely, okay? Then we're going to add a pinch of salt. It's going to be 1 full tablespoon of white pepper. So we're going to add a little Tony Sasseri's, about 2 tablespoons. This is regular egg that's been whipped up, and that's going to also help to hold the mixture together. We're going to put a little lemon juice in our mixture, okay? I'm going to add some wonderful lump crab meat, some fresh lump crab meat. We've got to add a little bit of hot sauce, and we've got to use my signature Dockside hot sauce. And you can add hot sauce to taste, you know, personal preference. I like to add a little bit to that. Okay, now, when it comes to the panko breadcrumbs, okay, this is 2.5 cups. In a crab meat stuffing, I like to have a lot of crab meat. So I got a pound of crab meat in here, and what you're looking for, a nice consistent color and a good mix. It's not only a stuffing, it's very versatile, guys, because I use it in the restaurant to make crab balls, crab cakes, and we also stuff fish with it also. Then you want to pull it closed this way, pull it closed this way. We're going to cover this up. We're going to set our oven at 350 degrees for 1 hour, and then it's going to be ready to go tableside.
Ernie, I tell you what, that is fantastic. Thank you so much. Yes, folks, this is a great recipe. We do a segment called Hook It and Cook It once in a while. This is a perfect proportion for my guests, and it will be for yours. I'm Gary Finch for 3 in the Morning. Man, thanks, buddy.
Awesome.
I really enjoyed it.
Fantastic.
Great day today.
Oh, fantastic. Isn't that beautiful?